Dans l'exil comme fable, ils ont pris mon histoire pour une fable. Pour distraire bataille et fontaine, réduire à un calé.
Very very gangster movie,
okay.
Thriller, okay. Set in Kinshasa, mm-hmm. And basically the story of this guy who comes back after many years and he has a lot of money and he wants to be like the king of the town. And of course, like a good gangster movie, there's a beautiful woman, dangerous, there's the money, you know, the bad guys, yeah. Yeah, it's a thriller.
Okay. But
we can say that like, the first film to shoot in Kinshasa. Mm-hmm. So people were quite surprised to see that there was a film and we were using local actors, mm-hmm. in Lingala, but mm-hmm. also with the crew. So people were really helpful in town. So okay. because it was also like an independent production, mm-hmm. sometimes we ran out of money or time, we could ask people to shoot in their houses, borrow oh. their cars in the street. So all that was really fun.
And, we and the community was yeah, really yeah, receptive.
Yeah, yeah, exactly, oh, absolutely. And, okay. And sometimes, I mean, as a director, you know, you have to take decisions every day.
Right.
And then suddenly you come to people and say, can I get into your house? Mm-hmm. And they were so welcoming. You know, sometimes I feel embarrassed, but I need to make the film. But that, yeah, that's how it was. It was really great.
With, do you think the audience will take away from after seeing Viva Riva? What do you think they'll leave with?
Which kind of audience? The black community audience or the others or whatever?
We'll say the
important question.
The African-American community.
Well, I think they will get a sense of like, they will see Africa differently.
Okay.
That's for sure. Okay. And I think this film is also a way to relate to Africa and to mm-hmm. Kinshasa mm-hmm. In a much more entertaining way that, mm-hmm. that they used to be, mm-hmm. you know. And I was writing a mail to a friend of mine and say, hopefully people will offer DVDs, their colleagues say,
right.
This comes from Africa. So right. That is like what I think they'll get. The other thing, which is like probably people will be, that will be the minor aspect of it. People expect to see that, oh, we need to have a story which is positive, which is like a fairy tale,
right.
Et cetera. So I think people expect that, mm-hmm. which they don't get in the film, mm-hmm. okay? Mm-hmm. But this is a gangster movie, mm-hmm. classic gangster movie. And I didn't want to give that ideal image of Africa because I don't think it's worthy now.
Right.
But what they will get is a sense of like, okay, this is like a documentary, but mm-hmm. at the same time, it's thrilling, at the same time, there are good actors, at the same time, the story is compelling. So I hope that they won't get into the film
okay.
thinking that, okay, we need like to have this positive image or whatever. Mm-hmm. They need to go to find a nice story, and I hope mm-hmm. they'll get that.
Okay.
And for the others, I will say, the general audience, I think they. It's an opportunity to have a story which is different,
mm-hmm.
and I hope they'll enjoy the story. But that's what's happening in the festival so far. So,
okay. Why do you think that maybe a black or African American audience hasn't widely accepted African films as of yet?
Well, I mean, answers are. I mean, it's a complex
yeah.
question that you're you're asking, and answers are various. But I will say, the most important thing is that. As a director
mm-hmm.
or as an artist, mm-hmm. we have a responsibility to bring material that people will be able to like.
Right.
Okay, because I mean, the world is a challenge. We have films from everywhere, including mm-hmm. America.
Mm-hmm.
And so, even before being a black filmmaker, you're first a filmmaker. So, you
right.
need to deliver a film which will be accessible to people
mm-hmm.
and they may enjoy it.
Mm-hmm.
But now, historically, I mean, our culture had a lot of problems and conflict in the society.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, as African, we were colonized, and after independence, there was all this rage and all this, I will say, we didn't have all the support
mm-hmm.
to get access to the industry,
mm-hmm.
okay, and nobody helped us,
right.
you know, in a sense,
right.
okay.
Mm-hmm.
So we had to find our way by ourselves. So
mm-hmm.
it took some time.
Mm-hmm.
And when you get to that point, mm-hmm. I think the first reaction, you want to put in all your, I would say, maybe anger,
mm-hmm.
all the political and all the difficulties that mm-hmm. are in society, which makes that maybe some of the films mm-hmm. that were there before were maybe people were expecting some entertainment, I think. They were expecting to go and relax and, you know, to just see an African film or Afro-American film like all the other film and say, okay, this is like our movie too. And it didn't happen, but also for good reasons, because it was important, you know, to get to some steps where we maybe first have landmark, political landmark and artistic landmark, so which was not like maybe obvious for the big audiences. But now it's a different time. You know, we had Spike Lee to open the doors. We had like many African American directors.
And, you know,
yeah, exactly. And so all that has changed. And now for someone like of my generation, being an African director, and all that is material for me to work. So I can still make the political statement. I can still make like the artistic debate of what we have to do. And people will see also, probably relating to sex scenes that they will see in the reviews that are quite like obvious, which is like a challenge, especially in Africa. But at the same time, I think now it's time to feel comfortable enough, okay, to put a film where we can have address these political issues, but at the same time, put an entertainment, you know, which I think the audience that will go on Saturday night to watch a movie won't have a conflict to say that what's the film going to see. They can be sure that they're going to watch an entertainment, okay, and after that they can think about the things that they saw inside. You know, maybe I don't know if you could call it maybe a moment of maturity. I don't know. Maybe it's probably your time for a change. I'm sure about that. Even if all this is working very well, I'm still really uncomfortable because I would be really sad if the African-American community or doesn't get that film, or if the audience do not go to watch it, because you can have a good movies and you can even have a good reviews, but you know, to have that connection with the audience is something special. Okay, it's like a kind of a mystery, so you don't know how it works. I would really love to have people going and watch the movie. Now the only thing that's really important for me is the audience. Yeah, they are able to get it.